So I know these two are in, but they're not lining up with the center. The question is this the proper center that's here? Well, when I move it over here, that's when it's lined up. This is not lining up with the center here once it's taken out of the ghost phase. So I want to see if this has to be rotated and how it has to be rotated. So let's bump this out of the way for now. Let's move this down to the side. Now as we move this in, I can see this lines up perfectly. So it's got to be down on that side. Let's find our way back somehow. That's back over there. Okay. So that's what has to happen. This is rotated wrong. So ultimately what I want to do is I need to get this rotated. Now doing so is going to rotate these guys too, but that's okay. We can put those in later. I want this to stay where it is. If I were to do that algorithm, RU, 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 RI, this will rotate. It's going to rotate these also. But we can try to abide that later. We just have to get this rotated. Now, I would have done that initially had I been able to line things up, but that couldn't quite work. So what I need to do is I need to put a different edge here. So I need to do some deconstruction, and what's more, I need to make sure that I can line things up, that I can kind of keep track of things. All right, on this side. So eventually the corners on this side are going to be here. So that's what's going to be doing my RU, 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 RU. But this edge is going to be in play, and I don't want that to happen. So I'm going to move this down. So I have to remember that I did that. I've got to remember that I moved this down, and I moved this across. So I just have to remember to get this back. But I might end up messing a lot of stuff up here, but I don't really have a choice in the matter. So let's go ahead and rotate this all around until this side is facing down. So I have to do it twice, that algorithm twice. And the good news, nothing else really should be affected. So that means I'm going to do R, U, R, I, U, R, U, R, I, U. Okay? Once more, R, U, R, I, U, R, U, R, I, U. Okay. So now we have to recreate what we did, remembering how we got it back. This had to be pulled down to here, so let's move it back like so. Remember this again, like so. And this came up to here. Yeah, that's fine. Okay, does it work? And yes, so this lines up and this lines up. This got messed up, but that's okay. Now, damage control. I know this center is correct. What about the other centers? This is correct. This is not correct. So I need to be wholly focused on getting these centers back, and then I can worry about everything else. I also know this is correct as well. So this is still good, 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 and good. This is good, 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 and good. And my corners also seem to be good. So this is where it takes a lot of concentration, basically. Move this in, this is good. Other centers, this center is not good. Let me just be sure which are centers here. Yeah, this center here is not good. So this has to be turned. But turned to what? So this comes into here. This has to somehow match up with this center here. And how are we going to do that? Okay. So let's bump this out of the way. Okay, now I'm going to turn this like so. Let's see if we can't line things up. None of these line up. So we'll turn it back. Once again, I lost track of what's supposed to go where. This has to line up with this somehow. Oh, actually, I'm sorry. Not this, because this is the incorrect one. So, before I do anything, let me look over here. This center is not lining up with this. And this is the correct one, so I have to somehow get this in. Line it up with this guy over here, since this lines up over here. So, put ourselves back into a position where these can move. There we go, like that. Okay, so once again, this has to line up with this center. This does. This guy over here. So let's bump this out of the way. Boom. Now we'll make a turn here and see if we can't line it up with this. So make a turn. Like so. And now go splat. And you see this lines up right over here. So that's how this has to turn. Move this back over here. And this moves back like thus. Okay, so now I know that this has to turn one click clockwise. Okay, I also know that this is correct, this is not, and this doesn't seem to be correct either. So that's actually good news for how we're going to do this. This turns one click around clockwise. So once again, I need to have an edge that doesn't belong. This belongs, so we're not going to want to use that. Any other edges that don't belong? This one, and this one, and this one. So this is going to take some doing. But once again, I'm going to take this, move this down. Just keep paying attention to what we're doing here. So this comes down, and this comes across. So I just have to remember to move this back into position. To move this back. Okay. That's what I've got to remember. All right, now this is going to move one click over here. Like this. So we're going to be moving it from here. I believe. Okay, so it's going to be R U R I U R U R I U. Okay. That should have done it. So now we have to remember what we did. Okay, so this was the center over here. This is what we were trying to rotate. So this came across here, as I recall, and this came back. Okay, do we like it? Bang, we like it. So we can see this is in. Nope, I'm sorry, right here. This is in, and this is in. So these centers are in. Okay, now what about a center here? Now we didn't mess things up too much. Things have gotten a little bit messed up, but again, this is like the final hurdle. Alright, so what is the center on this side? This is the center. We don't know what belongs here. That's an unknown. So before I do anything, let's get this back, because that's going to tell me if the center is rotated correctly or not. There you go. Okay, so I think what we need to do is find the edge that belongs here. And hopefully that won't take too much doing. Hold on here, nope. Here, nope. And back again. Now my top layer, I fear, has gone really, really messed up. Okay, and this one? No, wouldn't that be nice? But nope, that's not it. Well, I know that's not it. Final hope. That's not it. Okay. So that's going to be the next phase, putting this in so that we can figure out what's going on. You can see this is fading more and more. Picking it up from here, I'm trying to move the correct one to this spot. Now, as I recall, it's a long, sharp one, kind of like this. But I actually think it's this guy over here. So I want to move it closer to where I need it to be. So I'm going to do an exchange from the on the triangles on the other side here. So what is this going to exchange with? Well, it's going to exchange with this. So this is going to participate into it. And let's see, which ones are this going to, is this going to be affected by? Okay, so this is going to come down here. So this is going to be the triangle at which it's going to... That's going to be the center of movement here. So this, rather this to here, this to here, and this to here. We don't really want this one to participate. Could it be that maybe I can just move this into position? Well, let's see. Kersplat. So yeah, that might actually work. Make sure we have ourselves in position here. So I think maybe this to here, and this to here. So let's see if that would actually do the job. Okay, so this is going to be the corner that I'm going to be using as my focal point of turning. And let's see what happens. So this big one comes down. And then down, down. Up, then up, down, up, and up. Okay, so this move to here, this move to here, this move to way down here, and this move to here. Now, rather this. Now this should be able to come into this position. So we're going to go down. Down, down, up, and then up, down, up, and up. Now imagine if this puzzle didn't turn well and I had to struggle with every turn. It would be pretty much impossible, but let's see what we did. This is now in, so this is now good. And the reason why I wanted that there is I want to see if the centers are now rotated correctly. So let's bring ourselves back to where we were with this. Let's line this up. So this is good here. Let's see, this is good here. Good, good, and I'm looking for the center here and I see this here is not good. So this is rotated wrong. So I'm gonna see in what direction is this gonna be to rotate it correctly. So let's bounce it off of here and let's momentarily rotate this in like so. I'll bring this in and that's not right. So bring this back. Let's see, this is a center. Let's try that again. No, I didn't move it from here. Oh, maybe I did. Okay. Let's quickly move it back just to make sure I didn't destroy it. So this is where it's supposed to be. Let's move it in this direction. Move this in over here, and that looks right over here. So this is the correct way to move it. There we go. Okay, so it's got to be down to here. Boom. Okay, so basically I have to turn this counterclockwise. And the way that that's going to work is, as I recall, I had to move these edges, the wrong edges in. So which one are wrong edges? Let's see if I can remember. But this has to move counterclockwise. So counterclockwise, but let's see, let's remember. This is good over here. Alright, let's see. Alright, so this edge is good. This is not. This is good. This is not. So these two are wrong. These two, I don't know if they're wrong or not. I suspect they are wrong because this doesn't line up. And it should. So this is wrong, and this is wrong, which is good. And then I have to juxtapose these guys. This edge is not wrong because it lines up. Okay, so these two, it's got to come from these two. Okay, let's move this into a place here. Okay, so what I need to do to rotate this is I need to move something into this edge space over here. And it's going to be one of these two. So what if I go like, well, was it one of these two? We remember, no, it wasn't this, it was this guy. So that's gonna take a little bit more doing, so this guy has to move in. So the way that I'm gonna do this, and it's gonna be some deconstructing and reconstructing, so I'm gonna take this, move this around into this spot here. So I gotta remember this configuration, and I'm gonna take this and move this up into this spot here. So I've gotta remember to take these guys and move them down. And that should be good enough to remember with. Okay, this has to go twice. So with this in front of me, edge, triangle, where's my corner? My corner is here. So that's gonna be so that's going to be R, U, R-I-U. Now we gotta do it again. R-U-R-I-U. Okay, now let's get everything back the way that we had it. So this, as I recall, moved down here by one click, and then this moved back here. We caused some destruction here, but that's okay. Now let's see if all of my centers are back. So good, and this didn't move, so that should be good. So basically all of my centers are now back. Now you may say, well, why didn't you do that early on in the solve? And perhaps I could have. Honestly, I didn't really think about it at the time, but to really line them up, you can see these corners had to be in. These triangles had to be in, and I wouldn't know if the triangles were right until these corners were in. And I wouldn't know if the corners were right until the edges were in, and I wouldn't know the edges were right until they lined up with the centers. So I kind of had to do that first. So now that I've done that, I'm going to do some damage control and try to get these back in. So first off, it's a matter of finding where these things have to be. But here's the thing. Well, we have a choice. I could start putting these triangles back, but the way that I did the solve to begin with is I make sure all the edges are in place. So maybe what I can do is try to get all the edges in place. So just to kind of introduce the dilemma that's about to occur, if I have all the centers rotated correctly, but I still have a couple of edges that are out, how do I put the edges in without rotating the centers wrong? So that's the dilemma with this, and eventually I'm going to come to a point where I don't know how I'm going to get the edges in that are out without rotating the centers which I already just put in. So is there a way, perhaps, of rotating centers without taking the edges out once I put the edges in? That's just going to come into play very soon. All the top and bottom edges are in place, and now that these centers are in place, I can see what edges are here are in place. So this is in place, this is in place, these two are in place, this is in place, I think. Nope, actually, I'm sorry, this is not in place. This, where's my center? So it looks like I've got, where's my centers here? Center. It appears that these two are in place. This is not. This is, and this is not. So could it be that I have two that are out of place? That would be a little bit of a mystery to me. Let me line these up again with the proper centers. Because it would be great if I just had three that were out of place. Okay. So what is out of place? Not these two. This one. And this one. Now I thought this was in place, but I guess it doesn't really fit that well. So this is out of place. This is out of place. And this is out of place. So that's three. Okay, so now that I have three out of place, how can I bring them back in? So let's line this up over here. Okay. Well, anytime that I have three out of place, all it should take is one turn of that to get everything back in place. So amongst the two that are out of place, you can see these two are in the same layer. All I've got to do is get this guy and move him up. Move this guy to here. Now, which direction is it out of place? It's hard to say, but I rather suspect this has to move here. So I think a clockwise rotation, so we can see where that goes. But I need to move this guy to here. So let's move him in this plane. So I'm gonna bat this out. Oops. Pay attention to what I'm doing here. Oh, actually, now I'm going to bat this guy out here, splat, and I'm going to put him into here. All right, so how's this going to go? This is going to go back by coming back to here, and this is going to come down. So I'm going to take this and move this into here. I just have to remember that. Okay, now that I have that, let's set it up on this side to do a rotation of these guys. Well, I can't because it's going to rotate the center. That'll undo what I did. Okay, I got to be a little bit more clever about this. So the way that this has to happen is I've got to rotate other centers to make this happen. So what I'm going to do is, this is another center, and I don't know if it's obviously not rotated correct, or maybe it is. This isn't right. This is right. This center obviously isn't rotated right. So what I'm going to do is, I think this edge belongs with this center over here. So I'm going to move him here. And if I move him here, you can see it fits. Whoop, nice and snug. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to go ahead and turn this center, and I'm going to move it until he's over to here. So this is what I'm going to be moving. And I've got to get myself lined up here.
At this point, you can see I'm getting very nervous about moving the puzzle. My perspective is starting to bend. I'm starting to lose track of what things are supposed to go where.
And it's going to be R, U, R, I. U, R, U, R, I, U. That lines up quite nicely over here. And now, before we get too confused, let's get things back. I just have to remember what went where. This went here, fits nicely over there.
Now, I should explain that about this point in the solve, I made some moves, and I didn't reconstruct it quite right. So whatever the algorithm was, it was not in the configuration that I'd worked so hard to put it in. So this is where you're going to see what I have, what I call ghost fatigue,
so we've got this over
where
here.
Something got misplaced, and I knew I was going to have to back up a few steps and try to re-put in things that I'd put in, undoing some of the work that I did, but I wasn't really sure what got messed up and how I can maybe salvage it. So you're going to see this sort of ghost fatigue starting to set in.
Maybe there's something else I had to turn first.
At this point, I really fear the worst. I thought that I had undone much of what I've done, and I have a new, completely scrambled puzzle.
Here.
You can see that my hands are shaking, my emotions are starting to wear thin, breaking out into a cold sweat as I thought that maybe I had to just kind of bag it and start over again.
Maybe this had
and then
turn?
Finally managed to find my way through.
Nope. Okay. Yep. This does belong back here. Okay, so see that I'm building up the center layer over here. My top layer, this got disrupted over here, so this is no longer correct.
So if you remember, all of my edges except for a couple were in, and all of my centers were also in. Now you can see that I have top edges that don't fit and centers that are rotated wrong.
Just want to explore. Bang. Okay, this actually belonged over here. So this belonged over here. I'm just wondering if I put that in too quick. Okay, so I'm going to have to do some damage control, I think, because this is no longer correct. This actually belongs up here. Somehow that got taken out. So to move this into here, I'm going to have to rotate this side here. So we'll get ourselves once again lined up. And I think this got turned upside down anyway. Alright, so we have R U R I U R U R I U. And that put that back in. That was a close one. So these are all back in. This is back in, and now we can take a look and we see that this middle layer is coming together with these edges. Doing fairly well. Let's rotate this around. So we like this. We don't like this edge over here. We don't like this edge over here. We're not sure, but we suspect the center is okay. We know that it is because this edge is okay. So all these edges are looking pretty good except this one, and this one. So we still have three that are out that have to be placed now that we've placed this back in.
So what you just saw was that kind of ghost fatigue where I made some move that undid much of what I previously did, and what you just saw was all damage control. And I finally got it back to the original configuration, but it took a lot of negotiating with the puzzle to do that. So now I'm back with the centers in and just three edges that are out, still having to go back to the process of trying to figure that one out.